Hey, welcome to episode one of Jason Plays Chess. Now, technically speaking, this is actually the second game I've played, but when I played this morning, I forgot to add the audio source to OBS, so I have to play again. And when I thought about it, I could have just replayed the other game and narrated over it, even left my video in this corner so you could see that I was actually doing it, whatever. In the end, it was just easier and I think more fair to just play a new game. And as it turns out, with the exact same settings, the AI set to level 1 in lychess.org, I randomly got white. So let's see if this plays the same way. Same opening. So far, so good. Now, as I was saying in my previous attempt at this, I understand some broad concepts like openings, middle control, so forth and so on. But I really don't know the inner, I don't know if it's fair to say intricacies, or as you can see here, I've gotten myself into a little situation by putting this knight out, even though I didn't have a pawn here. So there was really nothing other than this pawn to attack, which is supported by that pawn, and now this bishop is here. And I suppose, I think it's probably better to develop the bishop. And now that knight might be pinned there. So we'll do a little bit of this. And we'll see if we can get that guy to back up. So this is actually going a little different already than my previous attempt. So again, I'm trying to make sure that I can control the middle. I understand the concept of that. Although I don't know any openings by name or by sequence. I'm sure this has a name or a variation close to it. Although, I seriously doubt this is competent play. But hey, you got to start somewhere. My goal here is just to be able to get a feel for how live chess works. I've never played online before. And in fact, I haven't played chess in a really long time. I think that it's probably better to develop some pieces here. I think I want to move this knight. He seems to be in the way. Because I think what I want to do is advance this bishop up, get this queen out of the way. I can castle this side. That's probably the better move, isn't it? Like that. Which means that bishop move is wasted, unless I can get him out here, maybe threaten here, because that would pin that knight. Otherwise I would take the queen. Let's see what happens. Yeah, okay, so now I got that knight pinned, and I open up this area. That's a little better. I guess so far so good, even though a couple of little small mistakes. One thing I was wondering about this morning when I played was, especially at a low level, where this AI is set to a rating of 1350, which is still, I suppose, competent club level play, if you can force it into blunders. Now, I'm not a true 1500. I don't know what my rating is, but I'm not a 1500, I can tell you that. So I kind of want to experiment with that, and part of what I'm trying to explore is just to see how this engine reacts and see if I can spot where something feels like a mistake, even though I may not be able to articulate it in technical chess terms. Not quite yet. So I need to develop this some more. This feels weak, my development here in the middle. I'm kind of hesitant to put my pawn here and start this capturing routine. Even though I have the knight here. If I put this knight here, that seems like a wasted move. There's no point in putting it here because that guy can get it. I could develop here, but then that's there. So move up. So at least now I got this bishop supported. Okay, now I'm going to be forced to move. I don't want to trade material like this. Trading material is something, again, is a concept I understand, although I couldn't tell you the points per piece off the top of my head, but I understand that a pawn is not as valuable as a knight. So I need to move this guy. That is not a good spot. That's not a good spot. I could put him back. Yeah, let's put him there. And then I probably want to move this guy up next, right? Or I could go like this and see what we get here. I'll go ahead and trade. That's interesting right there. Put him back. Of course, now he's not supported. I probably need, yeah. That was a blunder. As soon as I did it, I blocked my own support. Now, what I need to be careful of. Put him there. Probably need to leave that guy here to protect that one. I'd like to move this rook over here, I believe is what I would like to do. Okay, now that opens me up. I'm going to trade material here. I lost my bishop. I might lose my knight. So is it better to trade the pawn for the bishop or the knight here? Or I could take my knight and capture that knight, which I think is what I want to do because that opens this up. That was some fireworks. This game is very different than the game I played this morning. This engine, even though it's set to the same and it's black like it was this morning when I tried before, is not playing the same way. Which is interesting. You know, I kind of look at that as, you know, as a typical video game, we'd call it replayability, right? Which chess should be given its set of all possible games. You know, given the number of pieces and the board structure and the moves per piece, I guess is a good way to say it. I don't like this pawn here, but I don't necessarily just want to give him away. What could I do that's interesting? And I feel like my instinct is to be aggressive, which is probably not a good idea, particularly given that I'm not horribly skilled at this yet. And of course, it's hard to talk and think several moves ahead. But again, I'm just trying to get a feel right now. Like when I had this little knight back and forth here in this whole sequence, I suppose it's a good thing to consider how that felt. And it didn't feel good. It felt wrong, even though I don't exactly know why or how to get myself in and out of it. You know what I mean? And I'm kind of hesitant to move this way with pieces because that queen is there with that rook. So maybe what I want to do, develop that way, bring this over. Yeah. Okay, this is feeling a little better. Maybe move that up. Give myself a little operating room here. See, he's kind of stuck. So I have double support on that guy if he takes. I think I want to develop that way. Supported by the knight. Right, rather than taking here and opening this whole, I'm assuming it's rank and file, like row and column. I could be wrong. Something easily to look up. Okay, so we're threatening that guy, which I would control those diagonals, which I suppose is kind of powerful. I really don't want to leave my queen open like that. He's supported here and here right now. And I can't advance. I could advance there, but I don't know what advantage that gives me. I could come back and take this guy, but that's another move ahead. When I could move here, force it. But yeah, that's not good either. I could just take here. and I actually didn't see that. I lost track of what color that bishop was on. That's a mistake. And now I think I'm gonna have some issues. I'm up a pawn. I'm down a bishop. I'm up a knight. So I don't want this guy to get taken. And I have no way to defend him when he's out there on his own. And he's not doing any good. So it probably pays, and I'm in check anyway. So I need to bring him back. And he's supported again, so that's an okay move. Yeah, I don't want to take him with the queen because this guy's here. Although I could do this and get rid of a rook. I'm going to lose it. But then I'll... Well, okay. Fair enough. I can do check there. That's a victory for this game for me. At least being able to put the computer in check. Now, what can I do with this is the question. Because I have my queen available, but I'm out of rooks now. And this bishop is just there. Yeah, he took a rook. I kind of just let that go. I don't like it, but I don't know what to do about it. Well, I didn't know what to do about it because it's in the past at this point. I feel like I need to force that to open this up. Yeah. I don't have a way to protect this knight now. I could just move up one. It's kind of a shame, you know, I had that pawn advantage for a little bit. I couldn't do any pawn development up the board, up, you know, relative to my adversary's side. So this is interesting. I got this king pinned there, but I'm not able to capitalize on it because of my material deficiency. At this point, I feel like if I stray too far, this combination of bishop and queen is going to advance down here pretty quickly and get me into checkmate. So I guess this is a point in an endgame when you're down where you try to play defensively. That's going to be a weakness. I could advance here and see what happens. I don't know if this is a good spot for my king. It doesn't feel like a flexible position, but because if this moves, I'm going to be in check right away. And these guys are stuck. I mean, it's only a matter of time before this rook comes down and takes here and then just moves across. So at this point, is it better to come out fighting? Try to force something? I could do something like this, which is kind of odd. Yeah. And now I could just take it this way. Oh, I'm in check. Never mind. I don't know if I have a way. Yeah, that works. That blocks it. That was an interesting little discovery. He's gonna take there. No? Yeah, I can't move there. See, if I go there, what I'd like to do is advance this guy, but that square is protected and that square is protected. So I don't have a way to stop this queen promotion, assuming it takes a queen, which I don't know why it wouldn't. But I can't get back in time either. So if it's the queen, it's going to put me in check. Is it better just to go ahead and move here now? So at least that guy's protected. I'm not doing anything else. I mean, he's going to get another piece off that. Yeah. I don't think I can attack this king this way. There's just no way to move around to do it. Yep. That's what I would do. But of course, what do I know? Just because I would do it doesn't mean it's a good move. I feel like this is just going to end on repetition. What if there's a way to... yeah, I was waiting for that. How do you withdraw or resign? Is there a way to do that? I'll have to check the interface. I mean, eventually... if I play a human opponent, which I will. Yeah. I don't know. This is almost over. I hope you guys are enjoying this. Yep, there you go. So at least I'm able to watch what the computer did and get a sense for not only how it plays, but how blunders are punished appropriately. Because there's times, like I just said a minute ago, where that's what I would do. But clearly that wasn't, at least from the computer's view in its book of moves, and its ability to make decisions, which obviously is competent, not the most efficient move to make. So I've tried to pay attention to that too. Anyway, I hope you guys find some benefit out of this. My plan is to release at least one of these every day so I can chart my own progress. What's nice is I can take this match out of LieChess and load it either into the analysis engine in the platform or offline in another platform. I might do that later on if I get into it. I find the whole concept of this interesting. I've always wanted to play chess, let's say, casually, competitively. And, you know, now that you're able to do it online, which you weren't when I learned how to play as a kid, I figured, why not? Maybe it's entertaining. So let me know what you guys think. You can always tweet at me, @TheRealJPittman. And, yeah, see you next time. Bye.